world's favorite pumpkin rolls. Today, we're at Miss Amy's Creations. We are going to go through the process of making these delicious rolls. This is what they look like when they're finished. And I hope you join me today at Miss Amy's Creations and go through the journey of making beautiful pumpkin rolls. Hi, welcome to Miss Amy's Creation. Today we are making pumpkin rolls. It is a fairly simple recipe. What we're going to start out with is our wet ingredients. I have 3/4 of a cup of pumpkin. If you haven't watched my video on how to make your own pumpkin puree, go ahead and watch that. So we have 3/4 cup pumpkin puree. We have 3 eggs. That's a stubborn egg. And we have 1 cup of sugar. And we're going to mix this all up. Get it well blended. For our dry ingredients, we have 3/4 cup of flour. To this, we're going to add 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of clove, and just 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Now I'm using my pink Himalayan. So we're going to add these right into our flour. And I tell you what, I'm going to use a spoon and just incorporate that spices into our flour. Now, you also, when you start mixing, you want to start your oven at 375 to preheat. This really goes pretty quickly. You'll also want your pan ready, which I use a cookie sheet. You spray it with butter spray. Put wax paper or parchment paper down on that and give it a little spray. I'll show you what it looks like here in a minute. But let's add our dry ingredients. And there goes my thing beeping again. It always does. Doesn't know how to be convenient and not beep at me when I'm doing something. And the first beep you heard was the oven heating. Now, you don't have to overmix this. You can use a hand mixer, do it real quickly, to the cake part. I'll grab my pan and I'll be right back. Okay, we are going to just put this in our prepared pan. And you have to watch this because it does not take very long to bake. This only goes in the oven for 13 to 15 minutes. So smooth it out, get it into all the corners. And this, let's just get the bubbles out. And this is ready for the oven. Okay, our beeper just went off for our cake. So we're going to get that out of the oven. I think that this one could stand another minute. So we're going to go back and we're going to set our timer for 1 minute. Now, in the meantime, while your cake is baking, you want to take a clean dish towel. You want to spread it with powdered sugar, and don't be afraid to use a lot of powdered sugar. That is going to keep your cake from sticking. So, and I'll tell you, there is no way to do this without getting powdered sugar everywhere. So, we also have had our cream cheese sitting out to get room temperature. So, after we take care of the cake, then we'll make our filling. Okay, our timer has gone off again. Now, what you want to do is be very quick about this. Look how gorgeous this looks. A beautiful brown. And we are going to take this to our prepared towel. And very quickly, this is why I said you can't do it without powdered sugar everywhere, you're going to flip this over on your towel. Then carefully pull off your parchment or wax paper, whichever you use. Now you have this gorgeous cake, and what we're going to do is carefully roll this up in a towel, like I said, and we're going to sit this on top of a wire rack and let that cool for about 30 minutes. Back for icing. Okay, let's make some filling for our gorgeous pumpkin roll. So what I have is 8 ounces of cream cheese, and I am going to sift 1 cup of powdered sugar into this. I like using this little strainer. I think it's a little easier than a traditional sifter, but so all this is our cream cheese, powdered sugar, and I'm not going to make you wait for the rest of that, and 1 teaspoon of vanilla. So that is all you need in this. So you're going to want to take this to your mixer and get it nice and fluffy. And then put it aside and wait for your cake to cool. Okay, now we are going to take our pumpkin roll off of our cooler. And we're going to have to slowly unwrap this, making sure that it's not stuck to your towel. Now this is still a little warm, and that will help with cracking. So we're going to put about half of this up here. And we're going to stuff it into our roll area. And I like to make sure there's lots of filling. Go as close to the edges as you can. And we are going to roll. I have a little bit left in my bowl. So we're going to roll this up. I'm going to take these ends and put just a little bit on the end to make it look real nice. And that is your finished pumpkin roll. One thing I'm going to tell you about the pumpkin rolls. These can be frozen and they will be very nice coming out of the freezer. This delicious fall favorite is going to a very good friend of ours, Evie. And I'm hoping she really enjoys it.